All right. Hello, everyone. Good morning. Good morning. Let's begin. So, a few things to do. I've got my to-do list here. I need to do the mouth, the jacket trim. There's some fuzz that goes on the trim here. Then, finish hands, tail, and bracelets. So, a few things. I also wanted to make some of the bandages that I see in this reference here. All right, so let's do it. So first thing, we're gonna make this wider. Try to just finish up the fluff here. The floof. Das floofen. I feel like there should be one more right here off to the side. So we'll do exactly that. We're going to take this, move it over, and extrude. Boom, and collapse. I think that tufts or fur generally needs to be creased in order to really get the shape you want. This crease here. Make sure it's even. How many birds do we have? Six. All right, that's okay. Thankfully, this character is just a lot of solid color, so we're not too concerned with making sure everything is perfectly texturable. Not in the same way, just because it's a solid color. That's the only reason. Yeah, there we go. Just a little extra floof there. It really helps sell the floofiness. Woo! Excuse me. All right, awesome. Character floofed. Let's turn off the clothing, make sure all of this is touching the mesh. Perfect. This is a little awkward here. Some of these tips need to be straightened out. Yeah, I think all of them do. So we're going to go in. We're just going to do a few cuts. Like that, and then take the tip and vertex crease it in order to return it to its initial position. But you can see that the tips are not the same shape at certain angles, so that's why we're going in and doing this to ensure that they are more consistent. Unsquished. Are they that sharp to begin with? Photogem. We'll give it a second. We'll give it a second. Hard to tell with that image. How about this one? I don't think they were quite this spiky. Well, whatever. Just take it and do vertex crease 0.5. Mildly less spiky. But yeah, look at that. It's so chunky. If I do this, crease it, doesn't move, which means I think they should be in the same position. Perhaps the shape looks different because that's exactly what I'm trying to do, but so that one did move. Okay. So I just want to ensure that they're roughly in the same position. Like that. Okay, so I mean, some of these we do want to go back and adjust. This one, perhaps. Alright, that looks better. This one, maybe I should export this to Unity now to ensure that shaders are working properly. It's going to switch to this view while it's loading. My hair's a little messy. Man, some days you're so tired. What's up with that? I don't want to be tired right now. I need to work out. It's got to happen. All right, we're just waiting on Unity to load. So just one moment. Take forever. My immunity. Perfect. So I'll make a new folder or Byron. Load. Unity is just so fucking slow. Show me this folder. Come to that path. All right, I can switch back. Now we're going to take character. File, just like this. File, export FBX to this folder here. Substance Painter V2. Boom. So now what we're going to do is create the materials we need. So we have the body. The clothes and the eyes. Those will be. All of them are going to be the Boyomi 8.1 outline. All of you will have outlines black. 0.2 with a fixed size of 1 meter. Right, then we go to the FBX model. Read write enabled. You sleep on shapes. It will be humanoid, but we don't have a break right now. And then we can drop this. All right. So some of the normals are inside out. That's why some chunks of this are black. But we can get a good feel for the shading, which we will set to skin. Do that. We just get a little bit of shading. Take the light. Rotate it. All right, cute. Looking good. And the tail looks really nice. These kind of blended normals. That's what we'll be doing for the hair where it touches the head. So it'll just go, there won't be any sort of sharp angles there. Let's go back. Select everything, Shift N to reset the normals. Export one more time. And then we'll go back to working in Blender. Awesome. Looks quite good. Especially like where the fur meets the neck and stuff. Looks quite nice. We're gonna up the resolution on the eyes though, or the eye lids. We want this to be like double at least, so we get much. There's no jaggedness at all. That looks good. Right. Cute. Take the clothes and we want to go to the color, just make it a little bit darker so we can see it easier. Alrighty then. Okay. Save. We'll close this for now. I just need to ensure everything's heading the right direction. My nose is running. Maybe instead of or a jacket here, I could try to hand or attach all the trim to the jacket, but it might be easier to make little tufts that go above it. They're not the same mesh per se, but just kind of floating above. That'll be a little bit easier to think about and integrate. So let's do that. All that really means is we're going to close off. So here, here. This spot's a little different. That's okay, actually. So we're going to run another edge down it. Excuse me. Goodness. Okay. I'll be right back. I'm gonna see if I can get some medicine or something. Oh, heat some water up for tea. Hopefully that will help me feel a little better. Just feel kind of sniffly. Ba 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 ba. That also works. And then I could dissolve this line, but I like that edge. How about instead of that, we take this corner and we do a little trick. This should work where we do this. Then we can actually just dissolve at least this one. Because now we have this. Dissolve. And now we have that closed off. Little simpler. A little more self-contained. Now this little edge here just goes up and then ends here. Nice. Clever. Though I still need to figure out this little section. Man, that looked goofy. What the heck? Right, there we go. And now we can go ahead and close this. Like that. Or even like. This. But that's odd. No, I don't like that. Interesting. That works. So, got that kind of taken care of. We'll have a sharper edge here at the base later. What we are missing right now is the little fold here. So, we'll want that. And it looks like there's a pocket here. It's a little vague. I don't think I'll put a pocket on the hood. But we do want it to feel like this section is folding over the. It is a little bit in the model, but we need to make sure that that's clearly happened. This. Just bring the whole section over. I think we'll do another extrusion on top. Of this whole section. Like this. Because that lets us go back in here. Move this so we get that fold in the right spot. Why this is creased. here. Crease there and there. No reason for it. We do have some hidden faces here. All right. Now, with that done, I think this would be a good moment to take the corner and do a little bit of this. That. So we'll let this little corner folding over. Definitely got a little messy there, but I think we're figuring it out. All right. All right. Get back, get my hana. But Excuse me. All right, this is, I do not like this little spot right here. How do we improve this? I could run another cut along there. It's just this little bump. I guess it's just this right here. I dissolve that. Still looks pretty funky. Still pretty funky. Oops. What the fuck? Let me delete that. Let me delete that. Close that. Odd. All right, we'll come back to that. It's going to get covered up anyway. I don't think I should be worried about that too much. But we're much closer to what we see here with this little corner coming down and the fold over the arm. It's a little bit too far to the side, so let's bring this in like that. Rotate them so they're not so squished. And this flap here looks very separate from here. So I could do a little separation here in order to emphasize that. Not bad, definitely closer. And it's also, it goes like a 90 degree out. So that would require some very direct changes. So let's do that. XV, delete that. Delete that. So we want this to go out to the side. A second here, like that. Feeling. Oh, that's hot. Let's back up a little bit. So, looking at this, should really be like this, and going out to the side very directly. little bit better. Heading the correct direction, I think. I dissolve that, gets really funky in this corner here. But we will be covering this up with fur trim. So I don't think I have to worry about that too much. A challenge. Much better. Okay. Now, this here, this curve, it's not what we want for the most part. It would be better to probably have a direct route between these so we get the nice curve. But it looks good. Looks good. Just a little funky in some spots. What if we did that? And okay, think that gives it the directness it may need. All right. Okay. Let's bring in the chest just a little bit because he's kind of breasts are a little too big. That's looking good. Okay. So now the trim. So let's analyze these shapes. So looking at it, clearly there is one chunk that goes all the way around. And to me, it looks like there's less to more chunks. So we have fewer chunks at the start and more chunks in the back. And they kind of have a direction to them, kind of this clockwise direction to the spikes. Looking at our tuft, I think what we should do is we'll take this section here. And face extrude along normals. We just want this to be, we'll want one section of the actual jacket to have the trim, kind of the base of the trim. And we definitely want. Oh, that's good. I should have just done that earlier. We definitely want this to continue all the way along back of the hood. We'll lower this right about here or so. Crease these. Perfect. And then we can extrude normals. We can decrease them. We can delete that. And we can anyway, and then we can run some cuts along this to increase and then break in. So now we have this very clearly defined section of trim. Perfect. Think it's good to have some of the shape in the geometry itself. Well, with this character, we'll all be in the geometry. Increase that. That looked funky. What should I do? Let's leave it alone for now. Okay, so now we've got the trim blocked out. Be nice for it to be a little bit lower, because we want it to be, well, it would look like it's hanging off his shoulders, except he has this big floof on the head. Gonna hide those for now. And let's move the geometry down. Actually, I can do it this way. Plus, move down right about there. Actually, more down right about there. This is a very confusing view, but we're trying to prevent the hood from intersecting too much with the back of the jacket. All right, that worked out pretty well. All righty then. Look at that. Perfect. So now the trim. So again, we have kind of this section done now, this base trim. And what we want to do now is make these larger chunks that are popping up. Just trying to straighten this out back. Get a nice smooth. Good. I'm going to try something rather different with the hood once we get to rigging, but that'll be a while from now. I'm taking some screenshots of what the face looked like in Unity. Just getting some nice clean. Actually, I could probably save the one for after the subdivision has been applied. And that's what we'll do. Wow. Rather have a very sharp end to the shirt. All right. Looking more and more improved as time goes on. Turn off the clothing. Oh, no, I want to let's get the trim done. Then I'll move on. Make these tufts. So I'm going to take one of these, duplicate it, separate it, have a. We're just going to line this up with our little tuft here. So something like that. That way we can run cuts like that. One tuft created. Sort of. Let's duplicate it, mirror it. And then merge it. Do something like that. Not bad. So I think the key thing is that these points do come together at the bottom. That way we can easily have it come back down and work with the curve on the trim. So that. All right, one tuft created. And then I do want to make the trim itself get wider the further back it goes. It should be pretty thick by the end. Like that or so, because we're going to make quite a bit of fur. Or at least really large tufts of fur. Now, overall, it's kind of a simple shape. We have one here, another one, so I think we could move this further back. Right about there. And then large one here, and then one final chunk of tuft at the end. Then we'll sprinkle some of these smaller ones. Okay, I'm going to take a point to duplicate it. Move it over here. I want to make this second one, which I will. Let's do this for now. Boom, 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 boom. Right, that should be good. And let's fill in these tips and begin the volume. Should be creasing it before I do that, but I keep forgetting to. This one's going to be kind of like a big ball. A big Tufterino. Awesome. So now let's get these cuts down the main ways. Move them out. Little, then just the end points. exactly sure if I should. Shade smooth. Okay. So this needs to come together nicely. Take all the boundary edges. Extrude them and shrink them. Should have done that with this one too. Boom. So I want these points to connect right here. This. That'll be my one way of thinking about how to bring this all together. Definitely need some more cuts on this edge, which we could go ahead and extrude, close. Bam, bam. And no decrease. Some of these sections we can just have loop back in on themselves. That would be nice. Boom. It's actually pretty effective. Boom, boom, boom. Okay. Super effective. Definitely be using that in the future. Boom. Boom. Kind of a mess. But we did it. We can go ahead and dissolve this guy. And voila, we have one tuft. That should be a good start. Oh man. I knew I should have separated it. We'll have to clear that one up in a second, but for now let's just focus on this one. Perfect. Bridge. Perfect. Yeah, a little puffball. Let's just do one. I should have done this earlier, but we want to do some cuts here just to get them nice and. Pointy. Excuse me. Okay. So now let's place the tuft actually a little bit thinner. And place it. Definitely a little big right now, but right about there. Okay. Now this one got real fucked up, but I know how. Should be an easy fix. There we go. So I think this is looking pretty decent. Neck so bad. but not as spiky as it should. As it should be. Just a little too small. I don't like, it's not chunky enough. So we're going to delete that one and start over. This time we'll reference the other side. I think it should get spikier. Let's do this a little bit quicker. I'm going to go to plane, or make a cube, add a subdiv, delete the bottom for now, made smooth. Shrink the top, lower it, and do face, extrude individual faces. Do it again. Shrink them. Shrink them. Then collapse. All right, so here is a spike wall. What do we think of that? Doesn't have that nice curve to it that the other one does. Or it's just a little cleaner. That looks nice. Like that a little bit more. Should we go in and kind of layer it? Add a mirror mod, looking at the jacket like so. Okay, let's just see what this looks like in Unity. Do 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 do. Because I'll also be able to change the normals of this to be a lot softer. Right now they're very intense. Oh. Ooh. So select, file, all right, tab A, shift N, make sure the normals are the right way. It's not bad. It's a little confused towards the end there. Like another smaller one here. Yeah, especially if we redo all the normals, then they'll blend very seamlessly. Still get the spikiness that I want. I'm not really a big fan of it. Okay. Fine. It's just messy. It doesn't appeal to me because it's messy. I like how clean this one looks. It's got the right kind of spike. Matches the drawing well. Maybe I'll just do this. Do a bunch of these ones. Just plot that out real quick. I can take one of these, make it smaller, go around and give it the trim for the smaller tufts. But again, they'll all kind of match the shapes that I want. All right, one more attempt with just some copy paste. If not, we'll go with making the whole thing by scratch. I kind of like that though. I think we just need a custom tuft for the middle end, but other than that, it's got that nice chunkiness. We need some more spikes going out this way, inwards. Yeah, if we just took these bottom ones and rotated them out more. Or deleted some of them, made some single spikes, and that looked pretty good. All right. So that's probably what we're gonna do. But all right, so I'm gonna take these, might as well combine them for now. We're going to add, I'm just gonna copy to selected. Wait, paint. Kind of like that. How can I change my view here to have aliasing? Nice one to look at. Jacket. Looks pretty good. Makes it look very floofy. Blends nicely now. All right, I think that's what we're going with. And in fact, I need to do that to everything else here too. What are we doing? We are stealing this again. Copy is selected. Turn this on 180. And change this to the body. I kind of like how that looks. Makes it look so soft. Maybe I'll just do that. This one gets a little difficult. Because of the tip of it. Chin there. The chinny chin chin. Yeah, so some of the normals don't do particularly well. There's probably some easy ways around that. But I like how soft everything's looking. I think I'd rather have that for such a stylized character. Yeah, it just looks so good. But again, some of it is getting funky. But the hair on the back of the head, that looks awesome. What if I did, like, half of that? 0.8. So that still gives it form. But it gives it that softness that looks really nice. Yeah, look at that. It's so cool. So I think we'll do that. But we're going to do it a little differently. We're going to make a cube that's subdivided. many times. Smooth. Cut it. Going to delete this side. Mirror that up top. Basically, we're just going to create kind of a block out of the body very roughly. This isn't about perfection. It's mostly about just having geometry for the normals in the right spot. Something like that. And then we'll switch this to this cube, because that way it'll be a lot cleaner. In fact, let's go ahead and slap on here a smooth. We'll do 10 times. Maybe not. Hide that one. But this time we're going to do it for everything, including the character. So let's go ahead and do this. Select all of them. Oops. Should I do the eyes too? Probably. Should probably just do everything. Interesting. Hello, Oaks. Happy New Year. Welcome. Good to see you. Hope you're doing quite well. Excuse me. Busy, but not too bad yourself. Do anything fun while you were away? Well, I got to see my family and stuff, so that was definitely the highlight of my trip. But other than that, mostly just working and the same old. It's the usual stuff, I would say. But it's been good. I've been having a lot of fun just working on these things. How about yourself? How's work going for you? Work is work. Fair. That is fair. Trying to make a very stylized looking character. We're getting there. Think we're getting there. Interesting, the material. Finally made some time over the weekend last night to mess up in Blender again. So I made a walk animation for the project I'm working on. Oh, heck, it's awesome. I'm glad you're finding time to animate. Oh, excuse me. It's definitely a challenge these days. Always something getting out of our time, isn't there? This is an Abby for a client or personal? This is a client project. Looks good though. Think this is the direction we're going to Thank you. Yeah, I feel like I've learned a few things. Every character is a little a new exercise, new opportunity to learn. I do think that this is probably my most cartoonish character yet, which is good. Very good. What happens if we do something like reflections and specular? Okay, so that's still. Odd. Look at those ears. They're so shiny. I think I'd probably want to use a matte cap. Do you remember what that shader was that looked like the Arcane show was called? In Unity, you'd probably just use a flat shader. But as for, I have so many Udemy courses for specific parts of Blender. There was someone working on a hair shader in the past that I've done. And he had a few courses. Let me see. But they're all our YouTube videos, I should say. Arcane hair shader. Yeah, so this guy. He has a hair shader, and then he goes over how to paint things like Arcane. And he has some just some very, very good stuff. But he also has other stylized shaders in his YouTube channel, which are very good. Interesting, the outline. Is it just me or does it look stronger on top? Looks very thin on the bottom. Yeah, that seems to hold true for everything here. What is that? Awesome. I'll bookmark him and take a look. I want to kind of come up with my own look for my animations, but I would like somewhere to start of look
Subtle shade and flat shaded.
That's definitely where I would recommend starting because there's a lot of good resources for it. And it lets you work quickly. A lot of the like physically based rendering, shading, and stuff just it gets tiresome after a while because it's all so specific. Is this one different? Interesting. Go ahead and start. Oh, multiple data transfers. That's no good. Do you ever render anything out? And if so, do you use Eevee or Cycles? Generally, I use Eevee. Cycles is nice, but it's just going to take quite a while. Generally, especially for cel shading, Eevee should get you where you want to go. I would use Cycles if like I'm rendering out just one image, one really high quality image. But if for an animation to get the like highest quality, it'll take a long time. It really the render times really add up. Really quickly. Too quickly. Let's remove the data transfer for now. Or I'm going to restart the data transfer. We're going to focus on just getting the hair and stuff to look proper. This. Why does it look like this? Gotcha. I use Cycles for when I used to do renders for products, display units as an old at an old job. Gotcha. Yeah, that would be like, and we'll set it on overnight. Used Lumion on computer. I had a hard time running MS Paint, so it took forever. Oh my goodness. That's some dedication. That's always one of those kind of jobs where it's like, oh, we missed one thing. And then another day. I'm just sitting there waiting for that render to happen. Perfect. Ideal. What is this? Ah, I know what that is. That is this. All right, I'll be right back. I just need to go to the restroom.
You are correct. I wasn't talking for the most part, but I was muted. Hello, Byron. Welcome. No, I was muted. You were right. Mutually muted. All right, cat twofers. Definitely a little point here if we can manage. I'm doing well. Doing well. I will be just going on lunch in just a moment, but we have made good progress this morning. Got pretty much all the modeling done. Hello, Jams. Welcome. Yeah, we got most of the modeling done. A little bit more to do on the tail. And then we've got to clean up the hands, do the tail, bracelets, do the band-aids too, and then that's pretty much it. Gosh darn. Yeah, we're moving pretty quickly right now. And I put him in Unity to get a better idea of how the stylized shading would be coming out. Which it looks a lot better in Unity. Don't have to do the band. Okay. Then I shan't. I won't. But yeah, the fluff looks really good in Unity. Extra floofy. I got a new emote and I already made so many bad jokes already. Uh-oh. The power. Yeah, he's looking good. I'm excited to get him his coloring on him. This is emo guzzling. Is that mayonnaise? A roux chug. I can imagine. Oh, there we go. Okay, much better. Alright, sorry. I've got some song stuck in my head this morning. And tail time. So he has just a few little tufts closer. So we got that one in. We'll go ahead and duplicate this. And some smaller ones.
here. So do something like that. And maybe a little bit smaller on these ones. Bow, 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 bow. All right, that looks good. And maybe just one little chunky fur. This one towards the base. Fur. Oh, dang it. If it's feeling properly fluffy, maybe one more right down here. We're good. This just goes out a little too far right here. Let's see what it looks like in Unity. Unity. Oh yeah, fluffy. Maybe just need one or two more along the back, and then good. Some longer ones back here. Oh, yeah. Proper floof. Just one more down here, and we're done.
So I'm pressing anything different there. Okay. I think we've got some proper fuzz. Alright, tail's done. Time for the hands. Well, tail's sort of done. It needs to be merged. Body. Stupid gum. Your body. Well, what the fuck? I'm gonna explain why it looked a little odd. All right, combine. Take these objects. And it all looks pretty good. I just want to take this part. I mean, that looks pretty good, just kind of tucked in there. Whatever. How many here? Five and eight. So we just need to close this. Yeah. Oh, I see what happened. I see what happened. There we go. He's like, man, I swear I did this earlier. And I had. Get rid of this one. From here to here should be five. Okay. Q bridge. No need to merge. Or Perfect. And we want beans like this, these beans. Know. Think we're going to delete these then. And after we get back from lunch, we will create new hands. And that will be, oh, and then hands and then bracelets. And then we'll UV unwrap everything. And then tomorrow we'll be texturing and rigging, which should go pretty quick. We'll have them done by Thursday. Well, most likely Friday. That'll be good. Anyway, I am going to go on lunch right now to go work out and go get some food in my tummy. And I'll be back and we'll go from there. But thank you everyone who has been hanging out. Jams, Byron, Oaks, thank you all for hanging out with me this morning. Much appreciated. And I'll see you all very soon. Again, just be back in about an hour and a half. Just gonna get my lunch in and exercise, all that kind of jazz. So see you then, and have a hope you've had a great day so far. Bye. Yeah.